So it's kind of tough when you're somebody like me who likes the outdoors but also likes good sounding audio. With earbuds, oftentimes I'll just wear one earbud in and then leave the other ear open so I can hear my surroundings, but still that's not completely ideal just because one ear is closed off. I've tried some Bone Conduction headphones in the past and honestly I was a little bit let down in terms of sound quality, but with these new Open Run Pro headphones from Shox, these are much different than what I've tried before. How's it going, folks? I'm Deswood Desfit, and these are the new Open Run Pro Bone Conduction headphones from Shox, formerly known as Aftershox. And I've been using these for the last few weeks, and these are Bone Conduction headphones I actually want to use because they're really comfortable, they're extremely secure, and they actually sound pretty good. Being somebody that likes the outdoors, I want to hear my surroundings, and that's both with cycling, where that's definitely a safety issue, and then even in the hills, where I may want to hear the birds and the bees. And for those of you that may not be familiar with Bone Conduction headphones, these types of headphones have transducers that sit on your cheekbones, which deliver sound via your bone versus your eardrums like with traditional headphones. It's an interesting experience and it's pretty neat technology. And if you've been a longtime subscriber to the channel, you'll know that I do try to seek out a high quality audio experience, and the Bone Conduction headphones I've tried in the past haven't really cut it for me, but these Open Run Pros do fit the bill. No, these won't have the bass response of something like an in-ear headphone, but that's definitely something I'm willing to sacrifice for the safety and awareness. I tend to listen to a lot of electronic music like the Chainsmokers as well as Cascade, and these do a good job. No, not head-thumping bass, but these still deliver a surprising amount. Where these excel though is with vocals as well as acoustics. So like with the Dave Matthews Band as well as Beck, those sound amazing. And then with podcasts, those are great as well. And then one genre of music that I found to sound actually extremely good is bluegrass. Where these may not excel quite as much is going to be in really noisy environments because, well, they're an open ear design, so you're going to hear all that outside noise. So they used to include earplugs with some of their older headphones like the Open Moves, but they've decided not to include those with the Open Run Pros. But just for kicks, I did give those a whirl with the Open Run Pros, and just like the Open Moves, what they'll do is they'll block out the outside noise, of course, but they'll actually enhance the bass a little bit but reduce the clarity, but it still does totally work in terms of blocking out the outside sound. And these can also get pretty loud, actually surprisingly loud, but it doesn't necessarily enhance all the frequencies, so you'll hear a lot more of the highs and the mids, but the bass doesn't seem to get quite as loud. And then these also have dual noise canceling microphones for calls, and I was pretty impressed here. So these sound really good for the person on the other end of the line.
So this is what the microphones sound like on the new Open Run Bone Conduction headphones.
And another reason I like these a lot too is that I haven't found a pair of in-ear headphones that have a good enough transparency mode where when it's windy, it doesn't make it sound like I'm in a hurricane. And then in terms of comfort and security, so these things have a titanium frame, so they weigh only 29 grams and they're nice and flexible, and I think it would take a lot to actually truly bend these things. They have a strong enough spring where they stay securely on my head, but they're still very, very comfortable. In fact, just because of the open ear nature of these where I'm always hearing my surroundings, I tend to actually forget that I'm wearing these, along with the fact that there's actually nothing sticking in my ears and there's no fins to speak of like on some other earbuds that may be uncomfortable for some folks. And then in terms of security, these are incredibly secure with both the fact that they wrap around your head and they go over your ears. I use them for running, cycling, mountain biking, and I don't worry about these things at all. And then for cyclists, you may be wondering how these work with helmets. So with a road helmet, no issues at all. And this does even have the retention system in the back. And then this is a mountain bike helmet, but this is more of the trail style helmet variety where it comes down in the back a little bit more. So there's going to be a little bit more of a challenge. So yeah, even with a mountain bike helmet that does come down a little bit more in the back, no issues here either. And I think that could be due to the fact that these actually have a little bit of room here. So they kind of float and they don't really sit on the back of your neck. And then one more test with sunglasses. And again, no issues here either. The temples of the sunglasses do sit on the little over-the-ear hook, but that hook is actually pretty darn small, so I don't really feel that pressing into my head. Could make an Arnold Schwarzenegger Terminator joke right here. So these do come with a soft-sided case as well as a magnetic charging cable, but honestly, I usually just toss these in my bag and I really haven't had any issues. And then these are IP55 water resistant, meaning that they're dust and water resistant, but you probably shouldn't submerge these. I've been using these for the last few weeks and I haven't had any issues with these. And one more thing I would mention too is that just because of the design, sweat doesn't really collect on these. So with in-ear earbuds, sweat can kind of pool in your ear a little bit and kind of collect in there. But with these, the sweat just kind of runs off. And then for controls, these have a button on the left-hand side to play, pause, and skip tracks. And then on the right side, behind your ear, there's going to be dedicated volume controls. These use Bluetooth 5.1, and they also do have multi-device pairing that you can enable in the Shox smartphone app. And I've used these with my iPhone, as well as the new Garmin Venue 2 Plus with no connectivity issues at all. Battery life is rated at 10 hours on these, which is pretty darn solid. And they also do have a quick charge feature where you can just charge them for about 5 minutes and you can get about an hour and a half of playback. And they do come with a magnetic charging cable that has USB type A on the other end. And for how these differ from the previous generation AeroPex, or what they now just call standard Open Runs without the Pro, the Open Run Pros have their ninth generation bone conduction technology, where the AeroPexes or Open Runs have their eighth generation. These also have a 10 hour battery life versus 8 hours. These also are gonna be a little bit smaller, 20% I believe, but they actually have larger buttons and they also have the quick charge feature. So these Open Run Pros are finally some bone conduction headphones I actually enjoy using because they actually sound pretty decent. Again, this is coming from somebody who does enjoy good quality audio. For my outdoor activities that do consist of a lot of biking, where hearing my surroundings is really important for safety, these do a great job. I'll still grab a pair of in-ear headphones with active noise cancellation for noisy environments like for flying and stuff like that, or in situations where I actually don't want to hear my outside surroundings, but for my outdoor excursions, these are going to fit the bill. Anyhow, if you like the video, if you found the information in this video useful, do me a favor and just hit that like button down below, and also subscribe to the channel for lots more sports tech content that's coming soon. Thanks so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video.